Hey, what's up? How's it going? I hope you're having a great day. My name is Hadid, and today we will be taking a look at the Alliance city in Ashran, and we will be able to see what this city is all about. We can also find some really cool things to buy in vendors, and we can just check out the architecture and check out how the cities look like. Let's check it out. So we enter this big castle, and I don't believe that there's much here, just like some stairs to go up, some prisons, I imagine. General Lizzie Heartbane. Can I poke her? Whoa. Calm down there. I didn't know that it was attackable. What can I do here? I gotta... Oh, okay. Okay, whatever. I'm leaving. I'll let the guards take care of it. Okay, the guards just don't care. Anyways, we're going here. Let's check out the second floor. That's pretty interesting that you can actually... Oh, here they are. Guards are taking her down. Nope, Lizzie. You cannot take the guards down. RIP. That's actually a cool mechanic. I guess on the roof there's nothing. It was just the cool thing is on the basement. And now let's check out the vendors. The vendors are one of the things that I wanted to show you guys. Because you can buy really cool things at the vendors. Here's this. Let's see. Check out this vendor. This vendor has the normal blacksmithing thing where you can repair. This is apparently a chef. Take all of my artifacts. Bring me enough of those artifacts, and I can gear up our knights and send them out into battle. How many artifacts? What do the knight riders do? Our best knight riders will ride around Ashran to protect and serve. So pretty much, every time you kill a mob in Ashran, or every time you kill a player, you get artifacts. And then you can turn them in here, and you will get reinforcements whenever you have a certain amount of artifacts. I don't believe I have some artifacts here because it's a new druid. But this is a cool feature to know, especially if you have a lot of artifacts and you want to support your faction with more troops. This is another cool thing that I thought that it was worth showing in the video. Was that there's light wells here, and obviously the graphic of the light wells was updated and looks pretty cool if you ask me. Like, and the heal over time is pretty strong. It's about 6.5 to 7k with critting of 15k. And this is one thing that I also really enjoyed, because sometimes especially when you're attacking a faction or a capital, and the horde can totally overrun this, but they implemented something for people to be safe in AFK, for example, and it is this debuff, which is called, or buff, called Hallowed Ground, and you're immune to all damage. You pretty much get a bubble, and you can just chill here and not get molested. Oh, I just right-clicked it, but that's pretty much it. And we showed you these two vendors here, but I know that they're somewhere. I was checking out the Horde, and the Horde has it really well. Well, classified. So let's see. Take all the artifacts. What do mage portals do? We will erect portals around Ashran that can be used to bring you back to our home base. Okay. Then we have here some more stuff. Storm Shield Quartermaster. This is the vendor that I was looking for, and it's called Crafticus Mindbender. And if you guys don't know, Crafticus is a senior game designer in World of Warcraft, so it's really cool that they made a lot of references to players and game designers in this area. So let's check out these things. So it requires one artifact, these, and it's an Ashran's invisibility potion. It gives the viewer invisibility for 18 seconds. So this means that you can just pretty much... I don't have any. Yep, I can't try it out. But then we can just check them out. Pocket flying machine. Use summon a pocket flying machine for 30 seconds. Which will return your artifact tokens to your faction's base for you and other Alliance players. That's actually really cool. Once you have a lot of artifacts, you just use this token and you should be able to bring back all the artifacts. Remember that if you get killed with artifacts on you, they will be lost and the other player can loot them. Then we have Preserved Discombulator Ray. Dismount your target and reduce their combat effectiveness for 5 seconds. It's pretty cool to dismount people and start a fight. Then we have Proximity Alarmabot 2000. Use explodes all hidden and invisible enemies within 15 yards of the Alarmabot for 45 seconds and prevents using stealth or invisibility for 15 seconds after detection. Only usable in Ashran. Okay. Let's see, LeBlanc's Piccolo. Emits a slumbering note, causing all enemy players to fall into a deep sleep, unable to take damage or healing for 8 seconds. Wow. This sounds incredibly powerful. Then we have Kowalski's Music Box. Emits a soothing tune to all enemy creatures within 30 yards, reducing their range at which they detect enemies, and the music box lasts about an hour until it has been wound up again. Damn. Then we have Flimsy X-ray Goggles. Grants vision into the enemy player's loot bags, indicating those who are carrying artifact fragments. This is actually really cool. If you're just looking for people to gank and make them lose a lot of artifacts, you can just use these and be like, oh, this guy has like 100. How am I going to go gank him? And then we have the Swift Riding Crop. I can actually show you guys this because it costs gold. So pretty much what you want is stock up on these whenever you get to Ashran. And then you have a bunch, and what you use it, it's one debuff or one buff, Swift Riding Crop, and it's so useful. You get mounted instantly. Check it out. No cast time. Boom. And it's so good to escaping fights and such. It's a really cool addition, especially for like if you're running away. I don't know, it's cool. It's cool. Just spamming it. All right. So, besides that, you have a couple things here. You have like some towers. You have this, the SOS Relief Flare. Use shoots a flare into the sky, alerting your location to all alliance within Ashran. I guess this is to ask for help if you're getting ganked. Let's try it out. What is that? It's called SOS Relief. Where is it? Here. Where? Oh, look. Oh, it's in the minimap. Look at this huge X that I put. Now everybody's going to think that there's alliance there. There's Hoard here. But that's actually really cool. Look, it's a huge X on the minimap, and everybody can see that you need help. Or you can mark up, like, example, if you're stealth and you see them. And then, look, this guy was looking for Hoard, but I'm sorry, man. I was just testing it out. And, yeah, that's pretty much the tour of the Alliance base and all the functionalities and all the vendors, I guess, that you can find in this area or in the city. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. It's pretty alliance based, and I'm pretty sure this base mirrors the Horde one. But in case you guys want me to do a Horde one, let me know in the comments down below. I think it would be too much to do the Horde one, because I already showed you guys the Alliance one, and being the Alliance is almost the same as the Horde. But maybe Horde players want to see how the Horde city looks like in Ashran. Anyways, make sure to leave a like to support this video and subscribe to join the family. See you guys later.